Everyone has experienced tight muscles or knots, and there are many ways to temporarily decrease the symptoms, but they almost always return. Hey everyone, this is Dr. Zach Greenwade here at Performance Sport and Spine. In today's video, we're going to talk about muscle tightness, what's really going on, and the best way to resolve it permanently. If you wouldn't mind pausing the video, liking it, and subscribing to our channel, we'd really appreciate it, as you can stay up to date with the most current content. So first, we got to dispel a couple of myths about why muscles are tight. So one, commonly people think that muscles are tight due to shortness or lack of length. But look at this. As I stand and try to touch my toes, my hamstrings are pretty short and I can't touch my toes. Yet I never experience any tightness through day-to-day life or limited range of motion. So it's not a shortness problem. And secondly, if you look at these two papers, they found that people that had persistent muscle tightness and pain had no difference at the tissue level compared to people that were asymptomatic or had no symptoms. So if it's not an anatomical issue or a mechanical condition, then what is this tightness that we're feeling? Well, it turns out that most cases actually are more of a perception of tightness, a feeling, than an anatomical issue. So now let's discuss the different reasons. The first reason is hypoxia, which is a lack of oxygen and blood supply to the local area and muscles. And this is most commonly caused by prolonged posture. And the best remedy to this is simply to move more, as moving causes more blood supply to the tissue level. So it's maybe breaking up your day some or taking a long walk at night, but simply just move more. Second reason is sensitization of the nervous system, and this can be caused by more systemic factors such as lack of sleep, high stress, poor diet, or poor general health. And the remedy for this is also simple. It's just things that increase overall general health, such as improving your diet, being more active, trying to improve sleep, decreasing external stressors, and things that help calm you down. Also in this group are the people that excessively foam roll or crossball certain areas. Now, this does provide short-term relief, but it irritates the nervous system. And if you do this too much or too frequently, it can cause to long-term persistent tightness. So it's important to over time try to break this habit. And even though it won't feel as good in the short term, it'll feel better in the long term. And then lastly, just overload. If you're asking the body to do more than it currently can handle, you're probably going to experience some tightness. So if your body has the capacity to do this and you're asking it to do this, you can expect some tightness. And the remedy for this is straightforward as well. If you're currently experiencing tightness after exercising, such as running or weightlifting, just temporarily reduce what you're doing and then build up over time and focus more on that than stretching or foam rolling. Hopefully this video demonstrates why using a foam roller or having someone use their elbow and just kind of mashing on tight tissue only helps temporarily and doesn't affect the underlying root cause. Remember, it's why the muscle is tight, not what. One thing to note is that people that have had severe trauma or surgeries and have had their limbs immobilized for an extended period of time will develop contractures, and this is a structural limitation, so this video does not apply to those cases. Thank you so much for watching. Muscle tightness is an issue that affects almost everyone, and it often is misdiagnosed or mistreated, so by following some simple, easy steps, you can help yourself long term.